What's going on, friends? Welcome back to the channel. I hope everybody had a good holiday, new year, whatever it is that you celebrate or don't celebrate. My good friend GhostNinjaSD recently had another issue with a dealership fucking up his bike. He went in for some tires and they dropped his brand new bike and then have been giving him the dick around with compensating him for it. I don't know if he's posted a video yet, but if you haven't already subscribed to his channel, check out the link below in the description box. Go subscribe to that dude, because I'm sure the video he drops on it is going to be fucking phenomenal. But listen to his story. Got me thinking about my own horror stories dealing with dealerships and bike mechanics. So I thought I would share some of these stories and a few things that I've learned over the years that might save you a little bit of heartache. So my first experience that I can remember with having just a fucking shit time with the dealership was taking in my ZX14R for tires. I got a ride to a dealership about an hour away from where I live because this is the only place that I've got the Pilot Road 3s that when they first came out. I get to the dealer, I wait around for a while, I get the tires. I'm about a mile away from the dealership and my traction control just starts going crazy. Fucking blinking lights and all kinds of shit. I stop and look. These motherfuckers installed the rim backwards, so the sensors are on the wrong side. I go back to the dealership, and the service manager has the fucking balls to tell me that his guy installed the tire exactly the way that he took it off, and that somehow it was my fault. Now, I know this is total bullshit, but they fixed the problem, no harm was done. Dude, I never went back to this dealership again. The second horror story is when I moved here to San Diego. I took my bike in for a valve adjustment, right? That's all I needed. But a couple weeks prior to that, I think it was right after like Cyber Monday or something, I bought a bunch of new parts online. I got new brake pads and rotors and brake lines and a bunch of other stuff. So I'm thinking, you know, they're gonna have the bike for a few days. I'm gonna be out of town for the next like week or two. They can take their time, put all this stuff in. It's gonna save me a lot of time, and I don't mind paying a little extra to have them install all these parts. You know, the bike is gonna be disassembled anyway. Well, everything gets done, but for some reason, they're having an issue installing the brake lines. The guy is telling me that there's a leak, not to worry, that they're gonna fix it, everything's gonna be fine. So I go in one day, and the bike's in pieces, and they can't figure out why it's leaking. Like, why is my system still leaking brake fluid? Now I'm pissed at this point, because now there's not just one leak, which they started with, now there's multiple leaks. So I take the bike, I'm like, fuck you guys, lost all confidence in your abilities as mechanics. I take the bike to another dealership, and I explain to them, hey, this other dealership, these other guys, messed up my stuff. I need you to tell me how much everything is going to cost to get replaced. And I also reiterated the fact that I'm not having them do the work. I just want to know what it's going to cost to get this system back to 100%. The next day they call me, $2,500. To get this system repaired, they have to replace everything because the ABS module has been stripped. And they just, everything needs to be replaced. My entire brake system needs to be fixed. I take the quote and the bike back to the original dealership and I talk to the owner and I'm like, you guys are gonna fix this shit. I'm not paying a penny for any of it. And it took them a while, but they got it fixed. And mind you, I never went back to that dealer again. And thankfully I haven't had any problems with it since. So all these experiences have taught me a couple of things. One, you need to make sure that you can do majority of your own maintenance. Now, I'm thankful enough that I've got the space and I've got the tools and I've got a lot of know-how where I can do most of the work that I need to get done myself. I say a good 80%. The rest of it is just, you know, where I took it in for a valve adjustment, which just made me kind of lazy. And just hoping slash assuming that the dealership was going to do a good job. So that's the first thing I learned. If you don't have any kind of ability to fix your own bike or the confidence to do it, every bike has a shop manual. And most of them will walk you through step by step with exactly what you need to do. They'll lay out all the parts you need and all the tools. If you take your time and research this stuff a little bit before you get started, I can guarantee that you can solve almost all of your problems. And if you're still not confident, ask a friend.
Hello. Hello?
Like somebody, fuck you back. No, your grandmother. Very old.
Your mother.
So that's the first lesson. Now, if you absolutely need to bring your bike to a dealership or a mechanic, the next thing you should do is do some fucking research. Like, don't just take your bike to the nearest mechanic because they're the closest ones. Ask your friends, ask other riders. If you're new to a city, you know, most cities have Facebook pages for, you know, local riding groups. Find out, like, who everybody takes their bikes to. And Yelp reviews, you know, check those things out too. Google reviews, like, all of those sites are helpful. Now, sometimes the reviews can be misleading because you can't make everybody happy. And if you're reading some reviews and you see some shit that just doesn't make sense, don't be afraid to ask the shop managers of what it's about. For instance, the shop that I do like here in San Diego, I recommended that shop to a buddy of mine. Same thing, he just didn't have enough time to do what he wanted to do, and I was like, hey, you know, the shop does a great job. I like the work that they do, and they'll probably hook you up. Well, he did not like the work that they did, and he had some legitimate complaints. So I took my bike in maybe a week or two after that for some work, and I, you know, the owner doesn't know that it's me. He doesn't know who I am over the phone, but I asked him, he's like, hey, you know, I see that one of your customers had this problem. I'm going to be having the same type of work done. You know, what can you do to guarantee that that's not going to happen to me? And, you know, the guy was super upfront about it. You know, he's like, this is a problem that we had, and this is, you know, this is the steps that we've taken to solve this problem. And I was really appreciative that he was super upfront about it and didn't try to hide the fact that they had an issue with one of their customers. And on top of that, you know, having known the guy that wrote the review, no, they hooked him up. They didn't make him pay for any of his maintenance. And it was a good shit close to $1,000 worth of work that they had done. So the ability to take that kind of responsibility, it made me feel good. And it makes me feel good that if I go back there and I have an issue, that they're going to take care of me. So do your research. The third thing that I think you should be aware of is that if you ever need to have any work done, make sure you get all that shit done in writing. And if they're going to be replacing any like major parts, don't be afraid to ask for the cores of those parts. You know, don't just take their word for it that they replaced whatever it is that they said they replaced. You have the right to get those old parts back. And you might have to pay a core fee for whatever it might be. Don't be afraid to ask for those parts back. Those are well within your rights. And if you have any issues, like Ghost Ninja did, or his bike is barely rideable, don't be afraid to know your rights and stand up for yourself and be like, yo, you guys fucked up and I'm not taking this bike. I mean, for us, having a brake issue is a safety concern, man. You can't be riding around with faulty brakes. That's fucked up. Now, that's not to say that the dealership should not charge you anything and give you everything for free, but at least give them a chance to make it right. You know, no shop is willing to risk a shit ton of bad publicity because they didn't want to take the time to make something right. Now, while a few bad, Yelp reviews might not do much, you know, over time those things add up, and if people are using these reviews to pick who they're going to take their bike to for maintenance, and they start noticing that the shop down the street is getting more business than they are, they might take notice. The power of social media can do a lot these days. So if you haven't subscribed to GhostNinjaSD yet, make sure you follow that link below. Check out his videos. He's got some really good stuff. Really cool dude. We've been on some really fun adventures together. And leave some comments below, because I'd like to know about some experiences that you guys have had. Well, thanks for stopping by. Don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram. I'll leave some links below. Go on, dude. Go, 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 go. You're in my way. Make sure you guys are safe out there. Take care of yourselves and take care of each other. And I'll see you all next time. What the fuck are you still doing here? If you stuck around this long, you gotta subscribe now. Hit that button.